If we start to look at the generalized structures of vertebrae, you'll see this is the posterior view. We have all these processes. This is the anterior view, this nice big thick chunk. On the anterior view, you have the body. This is the body, the nice large sturdy body. Coming off of that, this entire thing right here is referred to as the vertebral arch. So the whole round part is the vertebral arch. So right from the body, we come to this little area right here, which is called the pedicle. So you have the pedicle on each side. Now the pedicle will go into these things sticking off laterally. They're called your transverse processes. So you go pedicle, transverse process. Then this area right here is called the lamina. That means we go from body to the pedicle to the transverse process to the lamina, which goes up to the spinous process. Now this spinous process is the most posterior portion of the bone. It's what you will feel when you feel down your vertebral column on your back. Now if I say we have the vertebral foramen, well, how many holes do you see? Only one. That's the vertebral foramen. And traveling through that will be your spinal cord or the spinal nerves. If we look on the superior portion up here, we can see how it's nice and smooth. This smooth portion on the superior aspect is your superior articulating surface. Down here on the inferior, that's your inferior articulating surface. Basically, articulating surfaces are going to be what are going to touch the vertebrae above and below. So you have the superior articulating and the inferior articulating. So if we start at the top of the vertebral column, we have this vertebrae, which is referred to as your atlas. Atlas is going to be unique because there really isn't much of a body. It's this very large opening where the brain and spinal cord meet. So this is your atlas. Up on top here is where you'd have the articulation with the occipital condyles. From there, we go to axis. This is going to be cervical vertebrae 2. So cervical vertebrae 1, atlas, cervical vertebrae 2, axis. Now axis is unique because of this point, this sticking up protrusion. That's referred to as the odontoid process or the dens. So you have cervical 1 and cervical 2. The rest of the cervical vertebrae are looking like this. Now if you notice, we're going to have these extra holes right here. Those are called your transverse foramen. That's unique only in the cervical vertebrae, the transverse foramen. You'll also notice the spinous process has two tips. It's referred to as the bifid spinous process. So we have the normal vertebral foramen, then the two transverse foramen, and the bifid spinous process. Moving to the thoracic, you can see the difference here. Thoracic has a downward pointing spinous process. This is the downward pointing spinous process of the thoracic vertebrae. So here's our cervical vertebrae, and here you can see the transverse foramen and bifid spinous process. Here's our thoracic vertebrae with its downward pointing spinous process, as well as you can see there's a little bit of a smooth section right about here. That's going to be for articulation with the ribs. And then if we bring in the lumbar vertebrae, much larger. So I'll move these two back here. And the lumbar vertebrae, you can see it's much larger in comparison, much stockier processes. So you can notice the lumbar vertebrae has still the spinous process, the transverse process, but they're much larger, much thicker because of more muscular attachments. Here we're going to have our sacrum. The sacrum is five fused vertebrae. On here you're going to have all these holes These holes are called the sacral foramina. The top of the sacral foramina, we have the sacral promontory. So the nice protrusion here is a sacral promontory. The very bottom, we have our coccyx. Now the coccyx, more commonly known as the tailbone, but anatomically referring to it, called the coccyx. We have a couple vertebrae, three or four vertebrae typically, and this is the very end or the tip of the vertebral column.